What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I'm going to show you guys how to overclock your Nintendo Switch using the SysClick module along with the SysClick editor tool that is going to enable you to manage all the updated overclocking profiles through your Nintendo Switch itself. Go to the link in the description and download the latest version of SysClick. Should already have this updated if you have been following my Atmosphere update tutorials. Second, go to this link and download the SysClick editor.nro file. Extract the content and you're going to get these three subfolders. Plug in your SD card, go to the root of your SD card, copy the extracted contents and paste them here. Replace the files in the destination, copy the SysClick editor.nro file, go to your SD card, go into the Switch folder and paste it. So once you have followed these steps, I'm going to show you guys the next things on your Nintendo Switch. So on the Nintendo Switch, go to the homebrew menu and look for the SysClick editor app. Here it is. You're going to see a bunch of options. Go into games and you're going to get the list of installed games. To select the one that you want to overclock, for me it's Skyward Sword HD. Here you're going to get a bunch of options. Docked mode, handheld, charging mode through the USB or through the official charger, or just handheld mode itself. So since I'm on handheld mode right now, so here you're going to see all these options. These are the configs that are set by the developers and the community, and then there is the official docked and handheld mode. So I'm going to go ahead and select the one that is preferred by the developer, which is 1224, and set the GPU settings to official handheld, set the memory settings to official handheld as well. So once those are set, just go ahead and exit the app, run the game that you have overclocked. While doing that, access the Tesla overlay menu and go to SysClick. If you notice carefully, right next to the CPU, GPU and memory option, you can see your overclocked settings. So if you go to edit app profile here as well, you can see the settings that you have applied through the editor. The editor is a very essential tool. It cuts down the hassle of having to copy and paste the config file. It always updates the profiles, I think, and then allows you to set those through your Nintendo Switch itself. Now, me personally, I don't recommend this overclocking thing because I'm a bit careful with my systems, except for some games like Xenoblade Chronicles 1 and 2. So just use it according to your understanding, and obviously there are risks, even though there are lots of articles that says that it doesn't put too much stress on the system, but still I wouldn't take a chance. Do it at your own discretion, you know. So yeah, this is how you install the SysClick module and use the editor app for your Nintendo Switch. If you have found this tutorial useful, please make sure to like and subscribe. Don't forget to leave a comment. Your feedback is very important. And yeah, until next time, Dr. Brute7 signing off. Peace.